criminal.
What's up, guys? Welcome back, or welcome back to my channel. Today we're gonna get into the death of Karen. I'm just gonna call her Karen because if I try to say her last name, it's gonna be butchered, and that was not the correct term to use for this situation. Bruh, legit, when I say, like, there's nothing on YouTube about her, there is nothing on YouTube about her. I'm gonna say the government had shit to do with this. I'm gonna say something about the Kennedy assassination, and you guys know that I do not like tapping into government shit. And of course, LAPD, of course, they're always paid off. I mean, in every single fucking murder that I do, when the murder happens in LA, they're always paid off. But I mean, I always say it all the time, I can't even talk right. Hollywood, the government, you know what I'm saying? Put yourself in a stupid ass position and you know, murder will be the proposition. I don't even know what proposition means, but that's what they're saying. I will definitely try to chill on the cussing, but I can't promise you, I'm already channeled with spirit. Let's get into it and see what Karen has to say about her death. Apparently, she was found strangled naked on a couch, I think. I'm not even exactly sure. That this is one of them readings that, like, it makes you feel shook before you do it. So I don't know what the cards are going to say. I don't know what she's going to say. So let's get into this. All I'm gonna say in this case, I'm definitely happy to give her a voice. So we are going to look into what was happening in the background around the time of her murder. That's what I asked her. Plus, I'm legit too lazy to look it up and read anything about it. Like, I really don't feel like doing that. What I do feel like doing, though, is, side note, wish I had a laser gun to shoot through a wall right now, Skippy. And you guys saw in the video prior, like, it said something about her being a communist, not smart. All right, so first out, off bat, we got private achievement, personal definition of success, fall from grace. Let's see why. I don't know if she was a cocky person, but I'm feeling like shit really went to her head, like she thought that she was above other people. I'm hearing she felt untouchable. I'm also hearing three is a crowd. Okay, she's trying to cut someone off or something. I definitely see that out here. They're not happy about it. And I say they because it's more than one person. Okay, okay. And I think this was around the Marilyn Monroe time frame, obviously, because JFK was still alive basically at this point. She knew something about it, which I don't understand how she was a columnist and an actress. Like, I don't know nothing about politics or no shit like that. But all I'm gonna say is she ran her mouth, or was running her mouth, with people that she shouldn't have been. Pillow talk. Whatever her career path was, though, she was thankful for it, and you know, she thought it was a wish come true, basically, like all the stars do. I'm also seeing bitchy energy living in the past. I don't know if it was her or someone she was dealing with. All right, and I could just stop the reading right now. She's showing me that, like, there's two dudes that are tying her up. I see, like, this little rope or whatever. I don't know if she's cut, but I see blood. Like, they cut her before they strangled her. They strangled her to death. She was alive when she was bleeding. Like I said, I don't even know if she was stabbed, but I do see blood for sure. Then you got duh, and a lot of this shit that I can't say is sworn to secrecy. All I'm gonna say, it was a setup and it was paid off. Basically, she was chilling, watching movies and stuff, withdrawal, retreat, trying to find balance in her life. She wanted a break. But baby, break me off a piece of that Kit Kat bar. What I'm trying to figure out is, are these two dudes friends? Because I see her laying on one guy and the other guy's just there. That's just weird. Netflix and chill, threesome maybe. No, I also don't know if she had low self-esteem, because I'm seeing self-limiting beliefs, and usually with people that have low self-esteem, they do that. Hardcore partying, alone time. I don't know if there was drugs and alcohol involved in the situation, but I'm not seeing that. Maybe alcohol, but I don't know. Like I said, I'm picking up three people. There's three people all together. I'm picking up, like, the dude is the other dude's friend, and that basically it was like a tag along. I see conflict, disagreements, arguments. I don't know if one of them is her boyfriend or not. I just keep picking up threesome vibes, like her boyfriend or one of them. I don't know. They're trying to force themselves on her is what I see, though. and it doesn't match up with her values. She's not that type of person.
I'm sexy and I know it.
Like, I see them at the couch, like, tying her up, and I don't know why the color green is significant. I don't know what that has to do with anything.
Multiple priorities, time management. I'm also going to say this. The two men that were questioned in her death are the ones that did it. They lied. That's them.
I'm hearing smooth, cold, snake, smooth, criminal, and he looked smooth. I will say that.
She lived for adventure and excitement. She had a young soul. She knew how to have fun.
She had money, and she definitely had a lot of money pouring in.
Relaxation, meditation.
We're working so hard every night and day, and now we get the payback.
Take a chill pill. Okay, I definitely see drinking out here now.
Definitely picking up on her energy getting a little frisky.
Bruh, like, I don't even say frisky.
Hold me in your lap of luxury.
Disappointments, abandonment. One of these dudes used to, you can't keep running in and out of my life. They would ghost her whenever they felt like it.
I don't know what kind of relationship this was, but it would be the correct term as a situationship. It was not going anywhere, and you know, she would think that he was going to change, but he never was because he was a little punk bitch. He could never grow up to be a man. He was in it for the ass and the cash and the look of it all.
So stay woke, ding, 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 ding. When you're feeling sad and low, we can take you where you wanna go.
She was the goat. She was the escape from reality when he didn't want to deal with it. A doormat, basically. Sounds familiar.
Side note, what's it like to actually not hear a damn door slam every 5 seconds? Cause I can't remember.
Scattered energy, scattered passion, scattered lies, situationship. Here's the self-esteem. That's why she felt low. She dealt with dudes that just ran in and out of her life like they really didn't care about her.
You know it's hard out here for a pimp.
But trust me, this is not a murder that was, you know, made from passion. It was a setup.
Like, is a columnist, like some sort of spy or some shit? Because she knew something and I don't know how she knew it.
Delays, frustration, resisting change. It's over, sweetheart, because I'm never gonna love you.
You knew when I met you, I said I didn't want a relationship because I'm an immature asshole.
Emotional immaturity, her doubting her intuition, like the dude was never gonna change from jump. When someone shows you who they are, believe them the first time. Sometime this month.
This is where I picked up this, and can't even talk right. See, they don't even want me to talk. Assassination of Kennedy, she knew that shit. She called the White House, the FBI, I don't know who the hell she called, but she called somebody, and she should have never did that.
I also kept hearing Joe DiMaggio. I don't even think she knew who the hell Joe DiMaggio is, and I don't even know why I'm hearing Joe DiMaggio.
Maybe because that's what the fuck Marilyn Monroe did. Maybe this shit is all connected because it's a damn conspiracy.
Like I say, fucking betrayal. She knew her killer very well.
Leadership.
Let's not ask what our people can do for us, but what we can do for our people.
Snitch. She called and told whoever she told that this man was going to be murdered. Like, are you crazy? And we all know who set up his murder. Like, I don't know what the hell she was thinking.
I'm also hearing a head case. You know, they tried to make Marilyn look crazy. Did they try to make her look crazy? I don't know, because I don't know shit about her.
But don't quote me, boy, because I ain't said shit.
Isolation, lack mindset. Poverty? Was she fired from her job? Was she going broke? Because that's what I'm seeing. If not her, it was the gentleman around her. She was a confident person. She was also introverted. For you dumb motherfuckers that don't know, introverts, you know, are very smart and they observe everything. So maybe she picked up that she was going to be killed. My question is, why the hell was she talking? Why wasn't she minding her business, Karen? Trickery, you know, tricks up your sleeve. Like, what were you going to get out of telling? And I'm seeing a shit ton of money out here. I don't know whose money this is, though. no initiation. Like, you're not initiated into the government. Like, you don't know. Like, shut the hell up. Fame and fortune. Saving the president's life. Like, are you crazy? Listen up. You never know who's initiated. Let this be a lesson. Mind your business and keep your motherfucking mouth closed, because you just might get sniped in more ways than just one. Happy birthday, Mr. President. Happy birthday to you. I'ma send your name here for what it's worth. Unseen setbacks, misfortune. Was this something? Did those dudes know something about Kennedy's murder? Was she going to snitch on them like Marilyn tried to snitch on JFK? Just a question to theory. An emerging idea, lacking direction, making decisions off of impulse. That was the wrong move, sweetheart. Good night, sweetheart. Now it's time to go. Again, I'm seeing resistance to change out here, and I just keep picking up that situationship or relationship, whoever this dude was, or dudes, I don't know. There's some kind of love triangle or something. Something is not right and something's not adding up. They just keep referring me to Marilyn Monroe. Okay, and I'm also hearing JFK was a sex addict. Did JFK ever sleep with this lady? Because you never know, he might have. Looks a bit like Jackie, looks a bit like his type, if you ask me. And if you go back and look at my Kennedy reading, I said that Kennedy knew something about his death, that his death was coming. Did he pillow talk with this bitch? And like, I'm saying, like, you don't know, you know what I'm saying? Inner conflict, conflict with others. Like, I'm seeing her throw a Marilyn pissy fit. I'm just picking up a heavy sense of feeling overwhelmed. All the ladies who independent, throw your hands up at me. She's financially secure and independent on her own. She really doesn't need a man, but she wants one though. Like Young Hundell. I don't wanna be a player no more. I'm not a player, I just crush a lot. Please, I told you. Here's the murder setup. Let me act like I actually give a fuck about you so we can Netflix and chill. Again, I apologize for my mouth, sincerely. Ditzy mouth, clean it up with Orbit. Transition change again. This is not something, she doesn't really want to deal with this dude anymore, but we might as well just chill for one last time. He was a skilled player, same game every time, repetitive tasks. Like, she was tired of it. Like, people think that you're gonna wait around forever. Get the fuck out of here. It was all a burden. It becomes a burden when you have feelings for someone and they keep stepping on your heart. Like, I don't know why this turned into a love story, but, you know, her lover was her killer. I mean, supposed lover. He never was in love with her. He was in love with himself. Then we got imprisonment, victim mentality. Like, everything you do in life is a choice. If you choose to hang around people that ain't shit, you know, they're never gonna be shit. You can say you can't be a man no more, no more, baby, I'ma do it right. And we got new ways of communicating. Isn't that cute? The player always tries to do that. You know, people were saying things about him that, you know, he was saying, what they say about me is not true. I promise, I'm telling you. The devil is a lie. So, you know, we got drugs out here. We got trying to release baggage. I don't really know if there's drugs. It could be drinking alcohol. It could be. But basically, this was someone that she didn't want to be with anymore, that she wanted to get rid of. Friendship. But can we still be friends? Smiles in your face, buddy. Once your ass clap, fake love. Let my friends be enemies and my enemies be friends. Don't show no fake love. Don't pretend. Okay, I've seen this out here a few times, but I just didn't say anything. Spiritual wisdom, higher knowledge. She's a divine feminine. I don't know if she was into spirituality, into alchemy, or if she, you know, just started looking into religion. The sun. So basically, you know, she wanted to make a new beginning in her life. She wanted to rebuild herself, you know, from all the traumas and bullshit that she faced dealing with this bullshit ass relationship. Sorry for my language once again, but you know, she wanted to walk away. I don't know what the hell she was thinking about the Kennedy and all of that shit, but obviously it was out of retaliation. I see that for a fact.
Like, are you dumb, stupid, or dumb? I don't know what was wrong with females back in these days and why they would retaliate with running their mouth when it came to federal government shit. Like, are you dumb? Stuck in your head, put yourself in a chaotic position. High priestess, you can never, listen up, you dumb motherfucker, get anything past the high priestess. We see everything that you do. And I'm hearing wiretaps. Never play with fire and not expect to be charred. Dishonesty, imbalance, lack of accountability. I'm also hearing Inga. If you don't know who Inga is somebody that JFK fucked, and I think she was a Russian spy. Followed by mental clarity, new ideas, success, question mark, happiness. And I'm hearing free at last, but you're anything but that. Again, imbalanced personal harmony, you know. I'm seeing this dude again, like back and forth, back, forth and forth. Overwhelmed by choices, do I leave or do I stay? No, you need to reprogram your mind and drop that bitch. Don't try to fight the feeling, cause the thoughts alone are killing me right now. Out here looking like Bow Wow, can't get her out of your system. Wonder why. Despair, disappointments, missed opportunities. I don't know if the president got shot first or if she got murdered first, but I'm picking up the president's death being spread across the nation. Okay, now I'm shook. So there you go. I don't know who died, but clearly someone did. Who's on the menu tonight? That shit legit freaks me out when I'm channeled and then the cards come up while I'm talking, like, bruh. But I mean, they're in here. Like, my floor keeps creaking and shit. They're definitely making themselves known. Anyway, let's get back to the reading. I'll whip your head, boy. You know that I will. I'll whip your head, boy, with the back of the steel. Ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States is declared dead. Romance, charm, beauty. Like I said, I don't know if this is a woman that JFK ever messed with. I'm hearing Tupac. I get around. Round and round, round we go. I get around. Special delivery. Special delivery. Empathy. She knew her death was coming. Literally. Investments, long-term views, sustainability, like, so apparently, I don't know if she's still alive or not. I'm guessing that she is, but I don't know. I don't know anything about her life. I can only tap into what I see. I'm hearing public threat, FBI files sealed. Clearly, she's not dead because you got love, relationships, and compassion out here. He's coming back. Because you're a threat. After all, that is why JFK was assassinated. Allegedly. What America? All that pillow talk, wolfing on the net. Nigga, you thought she was a thug. Inner truth, manipulation, power. And I'm talking about money, power, respect, power, up in the league, initiation type of power. Guess we're gonna go back to fucking with this dude because I'm emotionally imbalanced and can't handle life, and I just snitched to the US government that the president was about to be assassinated. Oh baby doll, there was only one way in and one way out. There was no getting out of this predicament because you were going to be murdered. You know what happens to snitches that don't mind their business and keep their mouth closed, Karen. Diplomacy, huh? I don't even know what diplomacy means. I'm just saying what they're telling me. All of this shit is alleged, okay? I hope somebody finds some closure on this because clearly all the files and shit are gone. Nobody knows anything, but here's the backstory to the shit. That's all I can say. Believe what you want to believe. I plead the fifth.